Hello everyone, welcome to another session on game theory. So far we have covered the topics on simultaneous games of complete information, right? So we started with defining what they are, then we moved to various kinds of games that were pretty standard, and we saw that how to write games, right? We saw how to fill the form, how to what are the components of a game. So we have players, we have payoffs, players, actions and their payoffs, right? And then we talked about the concept of Nash equilibrium. So an equilibrium concept which used essentially the idea that the system is in steady state, okay? And we also covered best responses, and after that we moved to dominated actions, strict domination, weak domination, and finally what are symmetric and non-symmetric games, strict and non-strict equilibrium. So now what we have done so far, we have also seen that there are games in which there is no equilibrium, right? So the matching penny examples that we did. So now we will explore more along those lines, okay? So for that, we need some building materials. So let's do that. So when we started talking about, remember when I was telling you about how do players decide what to do. Remember, these are simultaneous move games. So before, say, a prisoner decides whether to stay quiet or think on the partner or the other prisoner, or when Rahul and Anjali, they are deciding what to do, right? Whether to go for clubbing or whether to go for stand-up. They essentially are working on what we said was a belief about what the other player would do, right? So this is the first thing that we are going to cover in more detail now, which are the beliefs. So we said that players, if you don't know what the other player is doing, you have to work on a belief, right? So just like these two examples, in all games we will be working with what players believe, what players guess the other players are going to do, right? So the problem is that this is a very, it's a very vague definition. So to be able to work with it properly, to be able to work with it in a more scientific manner, we will need to give a more concrete, a more precise, a more mathematical definition of what a belief is. Okay. And so we will do that using the concept of probability. Okay, so every one of you is aware what probabilities are, right? So these are the basics that should be clear. Another term that should be clear to you for this is what is a probability distribution. I will tell you briefly, I will give you a sort of working definition slash example of what a probability distribution is. But since all of you are in your fifth semester and you've already done 2 years in economics, I'm sure that you know what a probability distribution is. Okay, so I'm going to use that as a given that you guys already know that. Okay, so a belief, essentially, what we'll define it as precisely a probability that, say, I as player one attach to the actions of the other player, right? So jaise hamara kya naam hai, Battle of Sexes wala game tha, Barkov Stravinsky wala game tha, right? So you have your Rahul and you have Anjali, and each of them could go for either stand-up or clubbing, right? So now when you're thinking in terms of what Rahul would do, right? So Rahul is not sure, you're thinking of, you've put yourself in the shoes of Rahul. Now Rahul is not sure that Anjali kya karne wali hai, na? So Rahul now is now reasoning that, okay, let me place a probability P that Anjali is going to go for stand-up, okay? So with probability P, so guess to karna hai, to guess karna hai, to aisa hawa mein to guess nahi kar sakte. Hum generally bolte hai, 50-50 chance. But 50-50 chances is just one probability when you're saying that the probability is equal to half, right? So another, so to kind of take care of all possible cases, we are saying that Rahul assumes that Anjali will choose stand up with probability P, right? And then with probability 1 minus P, she is not going to choose stand-up, right? Ab jo dusra option hai Anjali ke paas, wo hai clubbing, hai na? So that means that with 1 minus p, she is going to choose clubbing. Because there is no third option of not playing, right? So not playing is not an option. There are only two options. And we know that if we want to exhaust the states of the world, the probabilities have to sum up to 1. So if p is the probability of, p is the probability that Rahul attaches, that Anjali will probably, you know, will choose stand up, then it has to be the case that 1 minus p is the probability that he himself attaches, that she is nahi, wo shayad uske clubbing jaane wali hai na. So for example, agar tum socho ke p, if he thinks that p is equal to say 0.4, there's a 40% chance that she will go to stand up, right? So that means that there is a 60% chance that she will go to clubbing. ठीक है, तो इसको ये जो p 1 minus p है, इसको बोलेंगे एक belief, right? So this belief essentially allows for all kinds of probabilities. P का value कुछ भी हो सकता है, 1 minus p का value obviously मतलब 1 minus p हो सकता है, but all values are allowed as long as they are technically probabilities. ठीक है, तो उसको हम अभी, I'll just formalize that in a bit. This, as we know, right, this is called a probability distribution. Right, so what is a probability distribution? Probability distribution is essentially a description of how probabilities are distributed over the support of any variable, any random variable. तो अब अंजलि के पास दो ऑप्शंस हैं, तो प्रोबेबिलिटी ये दो ऑप्शंस पे, ये नाउ दिस इज द प्रोबेबिलिटी दैट इज अटैच्ड टू हर गोइंग फॉर स्टैंड अप, दिस इज द प्रोबेबिलिटी दैट इज अटैच्ड फॉर हर गोइंग टू क्लबिंग, राइट? सो एसेंशियली द टोटल प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ 1, द टोटल प्रोबेबिलिटी इज ऑलवेज इक्वल टू 1, कुछ ना कुछ तो होगा ही, राइट? सो द टोटल प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ 1 हैज बीन डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड over the two possibilities that Anjali can choose. Anjali choose एक ही करने वाली है, ठीक है, but Rahul के दिमाग में लग रहा है कि अच्छा अच्छा जो भी उसका previous experience है इस game को खेलते हुए, है ना, हम सब मान रहे हैं कि these are all seasoned players, so all are experienced previously. So using that experience, using whatever source of data that he has attached one probability, he has attached some probability to S and some probability to C, right? So he has distributed the total probability of 1 among the two actions that Anjali can choose. इसको बोलते हैं probability distribution. और game theory में हम इसको बोलेंगे एक belief, right? So a belief is technically a probability distribution over the actions of the other players. क्योंकि belief है, तो इसका मतलब कि say if I am the player 1, then I am attaching probabilities to actions of other players. ठीक है, so this is what a belief is. Now couple of points. First thing, that a belief can be like this also. That means that Rahul is sure कि Anjali जो है वो stand up नहीं जाने वाली है, she is going to go for clubbing, right? And P is equal to 1, that he is sure that she is going to go for stand up, right? So both are allowed, there is no problem. Okay, so then you can think that even the pure, matlab jo strategy mein hum keh rahe the ki belief aisa tha, jaise humne usme kaha tha na ke prisoner's dilemma, right? So in prisoner's dilemma, in that particular game we said that in equilibrium, okay, prisoner 1 believed correctly that the other player is going to think, because that is the best response, okay, to any strategy of player 1. Similarly, player 2 also thinks that player 1 is going to choose king because that is the best response. Pata kisi ko nahi hai, beliefs hai. But ye belief attach kar rahi hai probability equal to 1 to the action think. Theek hai? So both of them, both these extremities are also allowed. The second thing is that this belief of player 1, this belief of Rahul, does not mean that Anjali is actually going to randomize. ठीक है, ये सब राहुल के दिमाग में चल रहा है. ही इज स्ट्रैटेजाइजिंग हिज ओन बेस्ट रिस्पॉन्स. ठीक है ना, तो उस बेसिस पे ये है. इट डजंट मीन दैट अंजलि इज एक्चुअली गोइंग टू यू नो फ्लिप अ कॉइन एंड देखना है कि कैसे चलता है, क्या आता है, देन आई विल चूज. अंजलि के हो सकता है दिमाग में फिक्स हो कि क्या करना है, बट राहुल हैज टू वर्क विद बिलीव्स. दीज बिलीव्स मे और मे नॉट बी कंसिस्टेंट विद अंजलि, वट अंजलि वॉज एक्चुअली गोइंग टू चूज, राइट? सो वी आर अलाउिंग फॉर ऑल काइंड ऑफ पॉसिबिलिटीज. ठीक है ना, सो नाउ लेट अस जस्ट फिक्स सम नोटेशन. How we are going to notify, notation and slash definition, what you want to say. So belief, we will say that belief of player I. All right. Is of course a probability distribution over the, so belief of player I is a probability distribution over the action set of the other player. Okay, so for simplicity I am just going to assume that there are two players. Technically multiple players hain, to hum wo minus I wala notation use kar sakte hain. All this material is from Watson, right? So we are starting with Watson chapter 4 right now. The notation that Watson uses is minus I, the one which I introduced earlier. You can do that, but for simplicity we can just work with a two player case. ठीक है, so probability distribution of the action set of the other player, right? And other player can be plural as well. So we will denote belief of player I as theta, okay, minus I, right? Or theta say J. This is the two player case. दो player में हम कहते हैं कि player I और J है, तो player I का belief about the other player is denoted by theta and the subscript is the जिसके बारे में belief है ना. तो I का belief है J के बारे में, इसको हम denote करेंगे theta J से. Remember ये theta J का belief नहीं है, I का belief है J के बारे में. Okay, so we will denote belief using theta this is essentially a function. So theta j is a function from the action space rather, okay? So it is a function from the action space of player j, you know? Her, it will take an as an argument an action of the other player and it will assign a number to it that lies between 0 and 1 inclusive. ठीक है, so just in our Rahul Anjali example, AJ क्या था? AJ was your stand up and clubbing, right? So this theta J then was taking, so theta in case Anjali, right? This is Rahul's belief about Anjali. So theta Anjali will take S as its argument and give out a number, say probability 0.4. ठीक है, similarly it will take C as an argument and instead of giving an arrow, this is actually equal to 0.6. so this function essentially assigns a value which is technically a probability. It assigns a probability to every action of the other player from the entire action set. ठीक है, now in case of two players, I've already told you this example that we have done. There are two requirements that we want on theta, right? Theta में हमारे दो requirements होने चाहिए. Since theta is a probability, any number that comes out of theta, so your theta j of any aj, दूसरे player के किसी भी action में, this has to be greater than equal to 0 because probability cannot be negative. ठीक है, and secondly the summation of theta j aj over the entire set, मतलब जितने भी possible actions हैं सबके probabilities तुम मिला दोगे that has to equal to 1. So these are your beliefs. ठीक है, नाउ अब हम राहुल की बात कर रहे थे, ये सेम चीज अंजलि पे अप्लाई होगी. अंजलि भी सोचेगी कि अच्छा राहुल का प्रॉब्ली आई बिलीव, मतलब आई हैव टू वर्क विद सम बिलीफ, प्रॉब्ली राहुल इज गोइंग टू चूज से स्टैंड अप विद प्रोबेबिलिटी क्यू एंड द अदर क्लबिंग विद प्रोबेबिलिटी 1-2. सेम फंडा अप्लाई होगा. अ रिलेटेड कॉन्सेप्ट, राइट, रिलेटेड कॉन्सेप्ट इज वॉट इज कॉल्ड मिक्स्ड स्ट्रैटेजी. ठीक है, अभी तक हम बात कर रहे थे कि राहुल को लगता है अंजलि क्या करने वाली है. ठीक है, एक राहुल गैस वर्क कर रहा है, हमने ये कहा कि दिस गैस वर्क डज नॉट मीन दैट अंजलि एक्चुअली कोई कॉइन फ्लिप करके या एक्चुअली कोई यू नो डाइस रोल करके या कोई रैंडम नंबर जनरेट करके अपने एक्शंस लेने वाली है. राहुल्स बिलीव डज नॉट इम्प्लाई दैट, बट दैट इज पॉसिबल, राइट. अंजलि कैन एक्चुअली चूज वन ऑफ द टू एक्शंस बेस्ड ऑन यू नो सम डाई रोल, बेस्ड ऑन सम सॉर्ट ऑफ रैंडमाइजेशन. ठीक है, तो जब एक्चुअली में अंजलि ऐसा करे तो उस स्ट्रैटेजी, एक स्ट्रैटेजी क्या है अंजलि की, एक स्ट्रैटेजी है दैट शी चूजेस स्टैंड अप, एक और स्ट्रैटेजी है दैट शी चूजेस क्लबिंग, एक तीसरी स्ट्रैटेजी है. नाउ दीज टू आर प्योर स्ट्रैटेजीज, राइट. अ थर्ड स्ट्रैटेजी इज दैट शी फ्लिप्स अ कॉइन, राइट. इफ इट्स अ हेड्स शी चूजेस स्टैंड अप, इफ इट्स टेल्स शी चूजेस क्लब. दैट मीन्स शी असाइंस, अगर इफ द कॉइन इज फेयर, so she assigns a 50% probability to stand up and 50% probability to clubbing. If Anjali is making her choice like this, then it is called a mixed strategy. So Anjali is essentially employing a mixed strategy as opposed to a pure strategy, purely going for stand up, purely going for clubbing, hai na, matlab ki sare ke sare probability usne ऐसा कोई कॉइन ले लिया जिसके दोनों साइड हेड्स ही हैं, जो शोले में वाला कॉइन था ना अमिताभ बच्चन, अगर ऐसा कोई कॉइन है जिसके दोनों साइड हेड्स हैं, जो खोटा सिक्का है अगर, तो हमेशा स्टैंड अप ही आने वाला है, राइट. और अगर दूसरा साइड है तो हमेशा क्लबिंग ही आने वाला है. दीज आर प्योर स्ट्रैटेजीज, राइट. ऑल द प्रोबेबिलिटी इज प्लेस्ड ऑन जस्ट वन स्ट्रैटेजी, ओके. एंड इन द केस वेयर पॉजिटिव प्रोबेबिलिटीज आर प्लेस्ड ऑन मोर देन वन स्ट्रैटेजी, देन दैट इज कॉल्ड ए मिक्स स्ट्रैटेजी. ठीक है, तो इसको वो करते हैं. सो एसेंशियली मिक्स स्ट्रैटेजी इज व्हेन अ प्लेयर रैंडमाइजेस. ठीक है ना, ओवर हर सेट ऑफ एक्शंस. सो टेक्निकली मिक्स स्ट्रैटेजी इज ऑल्सो ए प्रोबेबिलिटी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन है, तो ये भी, वो भी हर स्ट्रैटेजी को एक प्रोबेबिलिटी असाइन कर रहा है. बट फर्क क्या है, पहले राहुल अंजलि के स्ट्रैटेजीज को, अंजलि के एक्शंस को प्रोबेबिलिटी असाइन कर रहा था, अब अंजलि अपने स्ट्रैटेजीज को प्रोबेबिलिटी असाइन कर रही है. सो द मेन डिफरेंस, आई मीन द कंसेप्चुअल डिफरेंस, the intuitive difference between a belief and a mixed strategy is that a belief is assigning probabilities to the actions or strategies of other player, to tumhara belief hai, but a mixed strategy is your own strategy, tumhe pata tumhe kya karna hai. theek hai, so you assign probabilities to your own actions, to your own strategies. theek hai, so also a probability distribution, but over a player's own strategy or own action set. ठीक, so suppose अंजलि ने decide किया कि उसने जो है stand up को 40% देना है और clubbing को 60% देना. However way you want to decide that, that doesn't matter. Just that you have pre-decided के इतनी probability से मैं ये choose करने वाली हूँ, इतनी से ये choose करने वाली हूँ. इफ दैट इज हाउ चूज एन एक्शन. देखो अल्टीमेटली दोनों 40% अंजलि क्लबिंग में और 60% स्टैंड अप में नहीं हो सकती, वो पूरी की पूरी एक ही जगह होगी. ठीक है, सो डोंट गेट कन्फ्यूज दैट बिटवीन प्रोबेबिलिटी एंड द एक्चुअल रियलाइज्ड आउटकम. ठीक है, एक्चुअल रियलाइज्ड आउटकम हमेशा एक ही इवेंट होगा, बट प्रोबेबिलिटी विल बी द लाइकलीहुड ऑफ हाउ लाइकली एवरी इवेंट इज. ठीक है, सो अ मिक्स्ड स्ट्रेटजी विल बी द प्रोबेबिलिटी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ओवर वंस ओन एक्शन सेट, वंस ओन स्ट्रेटजी. सो लेट्स ऑल्सो फिक्स सम नोटेशन ओवर हियर. सो वॉट वी विल डू इज वी यूज थेटा टू डिनोट बिलीव्स, राइट. वी विल यूज सिग्मा to denote mixed strategy. So sigma is again sigma I, it is of player I only. Yaad karo theta mein player I ka belief tha and that was denoted by theta j because it was about the other player. This is a mixed strategy, that means it is about own, so that is the subscript is I itself, right. This is again a function from AI apne khud ka action set se to a number p, or let's say all right, to number p such that p lies in this interval. This is what we will denote. So suppose agar Anjali ye karti hai that theta I of stand up is say 0.6, theta I of clubbing is 0.4. isme bhi wahi dono cheeze apply hongi, that this any theta I has to be greater than equal to 0, right, and they have to sum up to 1. ये जो basic probability का definition है वो यहाँ पे apply होना ही होना है. And as before, say theta I of any action AI can be equal to 0 and it can be equal to 1, both are allowed, right. If they are 0 and 1, then these are called pure strategies. Technically, हर pure strategy mixed strategy है, but हर mixed strategy pure strategy नहीं है. ठीक है, so these are called pure strategy. मतलब if all the probability is placed on just one action, then it is called a pure strategy. If positive probability is placed on multiple or more than one actions, right, this is called then a mixed strategy. All right, so we have covered two concepts. Belief kya hai? Belief hai player I dusre ke bare mein kya sochta hai, dusra ho sakta hai randomize kare ya na kare. Agar randomize kar raha hai to uske strategy ko bolenge mixed strategy, and the randomization will be such that the total is equal to 1, right, and none of the probabilities are negative. So this applies to both beliefs and mixed strategies. Both beliefs and mixed strategies are your probability distributions over this action set. But farak hai, kya farak hai? Ki kiske action set mein. Agar apne action set ke upar hai, technically, I mean, bearing it down to the technicalities, if the probability distribution is over your own action set, then you are following a mixed strategy. If the probability distribution is over the other player's action set, right, then we are talking about your belief about the other player. All right, so with these concepts fixed, now let us talk about what are called expected payoffs. So now suppose Rahul is not sure what Anjali is going to do. So he thinks that 50% clubbing, 50% stand up का chance है, या फिर राहुल खुद randomize कर रहा है, राहुल खुद एक coin flip करने वाला है और उसने decide किया है कि whatever the coin decides, I'll choose that. So in either of these cases, whenever you're working with a mixed strategy or a belief that is assigning positive probabilities to multiple action of the other player, then you cannot be sure of your payoff by making any choice. ठीक है, क्योंकि तुम्हें पता ही नहीं है कि exact ये choice होगा. अगर suppose you decide that you're going to choose stand up, then you're not sure what Anjali is going to choose, right? So then you have to work with what are called expected payoffs. एक्सपेक्टेशन हमको पता है, अगेन अ स्टेटिस्टिकल टर्म, एक्सपेक्टेशन इज एसेंशियली एन एवरेज, राइट? इट्स अ वेटेड एवरेज, द वेट इज द प्रोबेबिलिटी. ओके, सो वी विल वर्क विद एक्सपेक्टेड एवरेज, एक्सपेक्टेड पे ऑफ, विच इज अ वेटेड एवरेज ऑफ पे ऑफ्स, राइट? एंड द वेट्स are the probabilities of a particular outcome. Particular outcome or an action profile. हमारे action profile ही outcome है. तो कोई भी combination of action होने का जो भी probability है, उसी उतना ही probability से उसका payoff मिलेगा ना, है ना? So let's I'll just quickly tell you the notation and then we will fix ideas using a working example. So the notation will be that the expected utility, okay, so Watson just uses UI, but to differentiate it from certain utilities, I will write expected utility. So expected utility to player I from any action AI, given, right, her belief about the other player's action choices, theek hai, this is nothing but this summation. So you are making the choice AI, samne wale ke paas jitne bhi actions hain A minus I, which belong to A minus I, right? Weight is the probability. So don't get too scared by the notation. Abhi jab hum example karenge ye sab clear ho jayega. Alright, so what we are saying is that the expected utility to player I of choosing any action AI, okay, given her belief of what the other players will do, given, suppose hum do hi players hain, to is case mein, given her belief about the action choice probabilities of the other player will be what? It will be a summation. Kya hoga? Particular tumhare action se प्लेयर आई ने एक्शन ए आई चूज किया, दूसरे प्लेयर ने एक्शन ए माइनस आई चूज किया, उसका जो भी यूटिलिटी नंबर है, जो भी पे ऑफ है, उस पर तुम अटैच करोगे एक वेट, और ये वेट है ये, एंड दिस इज नथिंग बट द प्रोबेबिलिटी दैट यू हैव अटैच्ड, दैट प्लेयर आई हैज अटैच्ड टू दैट पर्टिकुलर एक्शन ऑफ द अदर प्लेयर. ओके, एंड यू विल सम इट अप ओवर ऑल द पॉसिबल एक्शंस ऑफ द अदर प्लेयर. ठीक है, इसको करते हैं, करने से चीजें एकदम क्लियर हो जाएंगी. सो लेट अस वर्क विद एन एग्जांपल वेयर सपोज दिस इज द पे ऑफ मैट्रिक्स. ऑलराइट, सो दिस इज हाउ द पे ऑफ्स आर डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड. नाउ लेट अस ट्राई, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद अ बिलीफ ऑफ प्लेयर वन. So suppose player 1 का belief है, 1's belief is that, so 1 का belief है theta j, that means theta 2. So theta 2 looks like this. So you will see generally this is how beliefs are denoted, right? This means that player 1 believes that player 2 will play L with probability half, M with probability 1/4 and R with probability 1/4. ठीक है, तो इसको हम यहीं पे लिख लेते हैं सिंपली, हाफ 1/4 1/4. ऑलराइट, तो अगर ये बिलीव है प्लेयर वन का, इन दैट केस व्हाट इज द एक्सपेक्टेड यूटिलिटी ऑफ प्लेयर वन फ्रॉम प्लेइंग यू, राइट, गिवन थिएटर टू. This is what we have to find first. Okay, so what is the expected utility of player 1 from playing you, given her belief about the other player's action choices, right? What will it be? First of all, with probability, so see over here, what you have is playing you, matlab hum is row mein, इस रो में तीन पॉसिबिलिटीज हैं, राइट। अगर तो उसे पता होता कि प्लेयर वन एल चूज करने वाली है, राइट, देन प्लेयर टू इज गोइंग टू चूज एल, देन प्लेयर वन वुड नो दैट द पे ऑफ इज एग्जैक्टली 8, राइट। सो फर्स्ट केस ये है दैट प्लेयर वन चूजेज यू एंड प्लेयर टू चूजेज एल, दैट मीन्स दैट वी आर इन दिस ब्लॉक, राइट, द पे ऑफ विल बी 8, बट दिस विल अकर विथ प्रॉबिलिटी ओनली 1/2, ऑल राइट। सो 1/2 टाइम्स 8, इसके होने की चांसेस तो सिर्फ 50% है, क्योंकि बाकी 50% से तो या तो वो एम या तो आर चूज करने वाली है प्लेयर टू, राइट। देन द नेक्स्ट इज दैट व्हाट इफ प्लेयर टू चूजेस एम, राइट, इन दैट केस द पे ऑफ विल बी 0 एंड द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ दिस हैपनिंग विल बी 1/4। एंड द थर्ड ऑप्शन इज दैट शी इज हियर, कि उसने यू चूज किया और प्लेयर टू ने आर चूज किया। इस केस में द पे ऑफ विल बी 4 एंड द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ दिस हैपनिंग इज 1/4, ऑलराइट। सो व्हाट यू हैव ओवर हियर इज यू हैव पे ऑफ, यू समिंग देम अप, राइट, यू टेकिंग एन एवरेज एंड द वेट्स which are the probabilities, right? So you have payoff multiplied by the probability of you actually getting that payoff, all right? So when you do this, what you will find is that this is 4 plus 0 plus 1, which is equal to 5. So the expected probability to player 1, expected probability to player 1 of playing you, given her belief about player 2, is 5. In expectation, ab milega to kuch ek hi milega, right? If player 2 ne chahe L choose kiya to 8 milega, M choose kiya to 0 milega, R choose kiya to 4 milega. Milega inme se koi ek hi. बट इन एक्सपेक्टेशन जो प्री कैलकुलेशन हम करते हैं गेम होने से पहले, उसमें हमें 5 मिलेगा, 5, राइट, बिकॉज 8 जो है नंबर बहुत हाई है बट उसका प्रोबेबिलिटी 50% ही है, 0 नंबर बहुत लो है बट उसका प्रोबेबिलिटी 25% ही है, तो इन सब के बीच मिली मूलों के कुछ एवरेज मिलने वाला है, वो एवरेज है 5, बट ये सिंपल एवरेज नहीं है, ये वेटेड है, ठीक है ना। अनदर एग्जाम्पल, सपोज सो गिवन द सेम बिलीफ वॉट इज द एक्सपेक्टेड यूटिलिटी ऑफ प्लेयर वन फ्रॉम प्लेइंग सी, नाउ वी आर इन दिस जोन, राइट। द फर्स्ट केस इज वेन शी इज हियर, so the payoff is 3 and the probability is again half, okay, so what you have is probability half and payoff 3. Second case, we are here, payoff is 1, probability is 1/4, 1/4 probability times payoff of 1, and finally we are in this zone where probability is 1/4 and payoff is 0. So we have 3/2 plus 1/4, you know, which is 1.75. Okay. Similarly, you can calculate the payoff, the expected payoff from playing B for player 1. ठीक है, ये तो हो गया केस जब प्लेयर 1 अपने प्योर स्ट्रेटजीज इवेल्युएट कर रहा है कि गिवन माई बिलीफ के सामने वाले प्लेयर के ये यू नो प्रोबिलिटीज हैं. If I decide to play a pure strategy of you, my expected payoff will be 5. Expectation is maybe hoga, kyunki samne wale ke bare mein surety nahi hai. So there is only one source of uncertainty is about what the other player will do. because player himself is choosing a pure strategy. But what will happen if player one also decides, let me also randomize? Okay, so then suppose now the second case is your theta 2 is the same. So your theta 2 is half 1 by 4 comma 1 by 4. But you also have a mixed strategy, right? In which you choose actions like this. Right? So for player 1, her own mixed strategy says that she will flip a coin, flip a fair coin. If it comes up head, she will go with U. If it comes up tails, she will go with D, and she will never choose C, right? And the same belief about the other player, that the other player will choose L with 50%, M and R with 25% each. अब इस केस में दो सोर्स ऑफ अनसर्टेनिटी है. सामने वाले के बारे में तो वैसे ही नहीं पता था कि वो एग्जैक्टली क्या करने वाली है, राइट? देयर इज अ बिलीफ आई हैव अबाउट व्हाट शी विल डू, बट नाउ आई आल्सो डोंट नो व्हाट आई विल डू. दैट विल डिपेंड ऑन द कॉइन टॉस. ठीक है, तो अब प्री कैलकुलेशन जो इंसान जो एक्स एंटी कैलकुलेशन प्लेयर वन करने वाला है, दैट हैज टू टेक केयर ऑफ बोथ दीज सोर्सेज ऑफ अनसर्टेनिटी. ऑलराइट, सो नाउ इंस्टेड ऑफ सेइंग दैट व्हाट इज द एक्सपेक्टेड यूटिलिटी टू प्लेयर वन फ्रॉम अ पर्टिकुलर एक्शन, राइट? हम यहाँ पे क्या कह रहे थे, एक्सपेक्टेड यूटिलिटी टू प्लेयर वन फ्रॉम प्लेइंग सी, फ्रॉम प्लेइंग यू. नाउ वी कैनॉट से दैट. नाउ वी विल से दैट व्हाट इज द एक्सपेक्टेड यूटिलिटी ऑफ प्लेयर वन व्हेन ही हिमसेल्फ प्लेज अकॉर्डिंग टू सिग्मा वन एंड बिलीव्स दैट द अदर प्लेयर इज गोइंग टू प्ले अकॉर्डिंग टू थीटा टू. Given own mixed strategy, given player 1's own mixed strategy and belief about player 2, what is the expected payoff? ठीक है, तो इसको कैलकुलेट करने के लिए आप क्या करेंगे? Now again we have, what will happen is that now there are 6 possible outcomes. पहली बात, पहली चीज क्या हो गई कि ये कैंसिल हो गया, ये वाले रो का आउटकम कभी भी नहीं होगा, है ना? जब प्लेयर ने सी खेलना ही नहीं है तो सी एल सी एम और सी आर वाले आउटकम्स हो ही नहीं सकते, तो ये वाला रो हो गया कैंसिल. बचे हमारे पास 6 पॉसिबिलिटीज, राइट? और हर पॉसिबिलिटी का अपना प्रोबेबिलिटी है. 6 पॉसिबल आउटकम्स हैं, राइट? दिस 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 दिस. हर पॉसिबल आउटकम में प्लेयर वन का अपना पे ऑफ है, दिस 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 and this this this, और हर possible outcome का अपना probability, right? So what we have over here is that player 1 has assigned a probability of half to U and half to D. Okay, so then what is the probability that player 1 will be in this box? Player 1 will be in this box when player 1 chooses U and player 2 chooses L, right? And we have an AND, मतलब intersection पे है. And intersection का मतलब होता है probabilities multiply होंगी. ये वाला particular मुहूर्त कब निकलेगा? जब player 1 का भी heads आया और उसने U choose कर लिया और player 2 भी जिस हिसाब से अपने choices कर रही थी that she should choose L. तो ये दोनों जब probabilities का intersection होगा, मतलब you have to multiply both these probabilities, तब ये ब्रह्म मुहूर्त में ये वाले outcome में हम पहुँचेंगे. Alright, so now you had the first case where the payoff is 8, right? And what is the probability? With probability half, player 1 will choose U, with probability half, player 2 will choose L. So half times half. Similarly, plus the other option is 0, or its probability is half times 1 by 4. Okay, so This is half times 1 by 4 multiplied by 0, right? Plus half times 1 by 4 multiplied by 4. बीच वाले रो का कुछ नहीं होगा. अगेन यू विल हैव हाफ टाइम्स 1 बाई 4 मल्टीप्लाइड बाई 5, हाफ टाइम्स 1 बाई 4 मल्टीप्लाइड बाई 2 एंड हाफ टाइम्स 1 बाई 4 मल्टीप्लाइड बाई 8. तो ये सारे को जब तुम लिख लोगे, आई एम नॉट राइटिंग इट अगेन, यू विल गेट अ पे ऑफ 5. ठीक है, कैलकुलेट करके देख लेना, दिस इज वॉट यू शुड गेट. एवरी टाइम द सेम स्टेप्स विल बी फॉलोड. यू विल टेक द पे ऑफ of the cell and you will multiply it with the probability. When the source of uncertainty is just 1, you will just take that probability. ये वाला या ये वाला. जब source of uncertainty 2 है, तो मैं खुद नहीं पता तुम्हें क्या करना है और सामने वाले के बारे में भी तुम्हें नहीं पता. तो then you will take care of both the uncertainties. And this is how you will get the expected utility of player 1. From what? From using this particular mixed strategy and believing this about the other player. So, yeah. All right. So, now that we have learned the tools, we have learned about beliefs, we have learned about mixed strategies. Both of them are probability distributions over action sets. फर्क ये है कि किसके action set पे है. And we have learned about expected payoff, जिसका मतलब it is taking care of the uncertainty in actually arriving at a particular payoff. Alright? So ये सारे जब tools हमारे पास ready हो गए हैं, तो अब हम अपना चलते हैं to the concept of Nash equilibrium. We will revisit the concept of Nash equilibrium. And why are we revisiting? The reason is that we encountered games in which a Nash equilibrium did not exist, right? So games like matching pennies, उसमें Nash equilibrium नहीं था, है ना? कोई भी ऐसा pair of actions नहीं था, कोई भी ऐसा action profile नहीं था in which none of the player wanted to deviate. All right. So, matching pennies had no Nash equilibrium, but it had no Nash equilibrium in pure strategies, right? When every player was decidedly choosing just one thing for sure. Agar Rahul ne decide kar liya ki usne head hi lena, aur agar Anjali ne decide kar liya ki usne tails hi lena, right? Before every play of the game, if Rahul decides that okay, I'll choose heads, right? I'll just show heads, and Anjali decides that no, I'll just show tails, right? The equilibrium ho nahi sakta. Rahul will always want to deviate from this equilibrium, right? In the next play again, they decide ke chalo, Rahul says ki nahi, I will choose tails now, and Anjali says that no, I'll stick with tails because last time kaam kar gaya. In this case, Anjali will now want to deviate because match ho gaya, to uske 100 rupees jayenge, hai na? तो प्योर स्ट्रैटेजीज में, मतलब व्हेन द प्लेयर्स डिसाइड दैट आई एम गोइंग टू डू दिस, देयर इज नो नैश इक्विलिब्रियम, देयर इज नो नैश इक्विलिब्रियम वेयर प्लेयर्स विल नॉट वांट टू डेविएट यूनिलैटरली, राइट? बट व्हाट अबाउट एन इक्विलिब्रियम इन मिक्स स्ट्रैटेजीज? व्हाट अबाउट अ मिक्स स्ट्रैटेजी नैश इक्विलिब्रियम? वी विल एक्सप्लोर द पॉसिबिलिटी दैट देयर एग्जिस्ट्स एन इक्विलिब्रियम in which the player's strategies are mixed, right? So in which each player randomizes between her action options, right? But the system is in equilibrium. मतलब कि उस particular strategy से कोई भी player deviate नहीं करना चाहता. ठीक है, it will become clear. So suppose again in the matching pennies example, ठीक है, अब suppose कि both player 1 and player 2 have decided ke nahi, instead of deciding before every play, instead of deciding that I'll go with heads, In every play, I will flip a coin, right? And I will do whatever the coin says. I'll flip a fair coin, right? Player one says that I will flip a fair coin and I will choose accordingly. ठीक? Instead of showing heads, मैं उसी coin को ही toss करके decide करने वाला हूँ. Toss में heads आए तो I'll show heads, tails आए तो I'll show tails. And player two also decides that I'm going to toss the same coin and I'm going to show whatever face comes up. In a sense, or technically it means that the strategy of both player 1 and 2 is a mixed strategy that places probability half on heads, right, and probability half on tails, right, for each player. Ab isme dekhte hain ki expected payoff kya hai. Theek hai, suppose player 1 thinks that player 2 is going to play according to this strategy. ठीक है ना, ये जो player 2 का mixed strategy है, this inequilibrium will also be the belief of player 1 about player 2. ठीक है, I'll talk more about this in a short while. ठीक है, so if this is the mixed strategy of player 2, what is the expected payoff of player 1, right, from using this mixed strategy? So what is the expected payoff of to player 1 from using a mixed strategy like sigma 1, when the other player is also using the mixed strategy which assigns half probability to both? So isme kya hoga, in this box, right, in box 1, payoff is 100, probability is half times half, which is 1/4. So the probability of every, again remember there are two sources of uncertainty again, so probabilities multiply hongi, har box ki probability 1/4 ho jati hai, right, and we will multiply the corresponding utility by 1/4 in every case. Theek hai, so we have 1/4 times 100 plus 1/4 times minus 100 plus 1/4 times 100 plus 1/4 times minus 100, and this is exactly equal to 0. You can also calculate the expected utility of playing H given that the other player is going to randomize like sigma 2. You will see that this is also 0 because it is half times 100 plus half times minus 100. ये देखो, वी आर हियर ऑफ प्लेइंग एच हाफ टाइम्स 100, एंड बिकॉज दिस अनसर्टेनिटी इज गॉन नाउ, प्लेयर वन अपने बारे में श्योर है, प्लेयर टू के बारे में उसका पता नहीं है, सो हाफ टाइम्स 100 एंड हाफ टाइम्स माइनस 100, व्हाट यू हैव इज 0, एंड दिस इज द सेम एज द एक्सपेक्टेड यूटिलिटी फ्रॉम प्लेइंग टी. So what we have is that if player 2, listen to this carefully, if player 2 is going to play according to sigma 2, that means player 2 is going to randomize, assigning equal probabilities to both actions, then player 1 is indifferent between choosing H, between choosing T, right, and between this mixed strategy, right? Player 1 ke ye sare actions uske liye best response hai, sabse ek hi outcome mil raha hai, hai na? Best response kya hai, that you can do no better, this is the best that you can do given a strategy of the other player, this is the best that you can do, because जीरो से ऊपर कभी भी प्ले पे ऑफ नहीं मिलना है, चाहे तुम प्योर स्ट्रैटेजी चूज कर लो चाहे तुम मिक्स स्ट्रैटेजी चूज कर लो, तुम्हारा एक्सपेक्टेड पे ऑफ जीरो ही होना है, राइट? So that means that given sigma 2, all of player 1 strategies are best responses. And the same applies to player 2 also. Player 2 के लिए भी तो same है ना, zero sum game है जहाँ पे इसका plus 100 है वहाँ पे उसका minus 100 होगा, जहाँ पे इसका minus 100 है वहाँ पे उसका plus 100 होगा, तो mirror image ही होगा, right? But essentially same ही हो जाएंगी चीज़ें. So given that player 1 is following this strategy, every strategy of player 2 is a best response to sigma 1, right? And if essentially we have a combination of strategies sigma 1 and sigma 2 which are best responses to each other, right? Jis tarike se sigma 2 ke liye H best response hai, T best response hai, and sigma 1 best response hai, right? Sigma 2 ke liye sigma 1 best response hai. It doesn't strictly dominate these other two pure strategies, but it does, matlab, it doesn't make the player worse off. Theek hai? So sigma 2 ke liye sigma 1 best hai, sigma 1 ke liye sigma 2 best hai. We have a combination, we have an intersection, we have a case of Nash equilibrium. This is Nash equilibrium by definition, right? So this same applies to player 2. Alright, so this means that we have a Nash equilibrium in mixed strategies. So the definition of a Nash equilibrium in mixed strategies, it is also called mixed strategy Nash equilibrium, MSNE, short mein bhai jagah likha hoga. So a Nash equilibrium in mixed strategy is essentially a mixed strategy profile, right? Profile matlab har player ke liye ek strategy. Sigma is the profile, which is sigma 1 for player 1 and sigma 2 for player 2, and so on, sigma n for player n, right? Is a mixed strategy Nash equilibrium if and only if basically the utility or the expected utility to player I from playing sigma i minus i is greater than equal to the expected utility to player I from playing any other action when the others are following sigma minus i, right? For any other action and for all players, sirf player I ke liye nahi, player j ke liye bhi apply hota hai, same jo hamara funda tha ki jo combination of actions hai sigma I, sigma j, sigma 1, sigma 2, they should be best responses to each other. Agar aisa hai, then we have a mixed strategy Nash equilibrium. Theek hai? I'll give you a few pointers about a mixed strategy Nash equilibrium. Theek hai? First is that a mixed strategy Nash equilibrium, just like hamara ek Nash equilibrium mein hota tha ki koi bhi strictly dominated action kisi bhi Nash equilibrium mein ka part nahi ho sakta, right? Similarly, a mixed strategy Nash equilibrium will not place a positive probability on any action that is strictly dominated, right? So the first step that you can always do is eliminate any strictly dominated actions, right? The second point is that in equilibrium, this is something that I was talking about, we said that ye sigma 1, sigma 2 inke strategies hain, right? Sigma 1 and sigma 2 are the strategies. The problem is that we are still in the simultaneous move game in which player 1 does not know what player 2 will do, right? So an equilibrium essentially is a situation when player 1's belief about player 2 coincides with player 2's actual mixed strategy, right? So theta 2 is the same as sigma 2. Okay, player 1's belief is the same as the actual strategy that is employed by the other player. And similarly for player 1, you know? So similarly for player 2. So player 2's belief about player 1 coincide with the actual mixed strategy of player 1. Equilibrium ऐसे characterize होगा. जब तक ये belief और actual belief और reality में expectation और reality में फर्क रहेगा, system equilibrium में नहीं आएगा. System equilibrium में तब आएगा जब ये belief और reality coincide कर जाएंगे. That's why वो जो my beliefs are correct, that assumption still follows you. Just that now I believe that you follow a mixed strategy and you actually follow that exactly mixed strategy. If I believe that you follow a mixed strategy and your mixed strategy is different from what I believe, then the system will not be in equilibrium. ठीक है ना, क्योंकि I will want to deviate because then that I will be acting according to my belief, right? Which will not coincide with what is optimal. क्योंकि तुम्हारा actual mixed strategy के हिसाब से तो मेरा response कुछ और होना चाहिए. So if I am responding to a belief that is different from reality, my response will not be the best response to the reality. अगर मैं delusion में जी रही हूँ, है ना, अगर मैं delusion में जी रही हूँ तो जो भी action मैंने choose किया वो best response नहीं होगा reality के लिए. Reality का best response देने के लिए reality का पता होना ज़रूरी है, या फिर expectation reality से match होना ज़रूरी है. ठीक है, so in equilibrium your expectation will match your reality. Then only it will be in equilibrium. All right. First point was that you have no strictly dominated actions in your mixed strategy Nash equilibrium. Secondly, equilibrium will be characterized by expectations matching reality. The third point is that you have to understand that players do not strive for equilibrium. Matching penny mein कोई भी प्लेयर को ये नहीं लग रहा है कि हम इक्विलिब्रियम पहुंच जाएं. हर प्लेयर का मकसद है अपना जीतना. एवरी प्लेयर वांट्स टू विन व्हेनेवर देयर आर कॉन्फ्लिक्चुअल गेम्स. इन प्रिजनर्स डिलेमा एवरी प्लेयर वांट्स टू मैक्सिमाइज हर ओन पे ऑफ, राइट. नोबडी, नो प्लेयर इज स्ट्राइविंग फॉर इक्विलिब्रियम. यू कैन थिंक दैट द सिस्टम इज स्ट्राइविंग फॉर इक्विलिब्रियम. मतलब जो होता है ना कि किसी भी सिस्टम का एम होता है, एज अ सिस्टम, एज अ फिजिकल सिस्टम, एनी सिस्टम मूव्स नेचुरली टूवर्ड्स रिड्यूसिंग एंट्रोपी. जहाँ से डिविएशंस कम हो जाए, जहाँ से लोगों का भागना दौड़ना कम हो जाए, जहाँ पे एनर्जी कम हो जाए, एंट्रोपी कम हो जाए. ठीक है, सो एज अ सिस्टम थिंग्स मूव टूवर्ड्स इक्विलिब्रियम, राइट. एज प्लेयर्स, कोई भी प्लेयर का कोई ऐसा टारगेट नहीं है कि हम इक्विलिब्रियम पहुंच जाएं, हम ऐसी जगह पहुंच जाएं जहां पे किसी को डेविएट करने का मन ना, राइट. सो यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस डिफरेंस दैट एज प्लेयर्स दे डोंट वांट टू गो टू इक्विलिब्रियम. आई मीन डोंट वांट टू, नहीं जा रहे हैं कि नहीं जा रहे हैं उससे उन्हें फर्क नहीं है. दे डोंट केयर अबाउट इक्विलिब्रियम. एंड अ सिस्टम इज अ, व्हाट डू यू से, इट्स अ नॉन कॉन्शियस थिंग, राइट. इट्स अ फिजिकल थिंग that is programmed to move towards equilibrium. So we are studying this system, we are studying the system that is programmed to move towards equilibrium. It may or may not, but what we are trying to study is ki jab equilibrium mein hoga to equilibrium kaisa lagega, wo steady state kaisa lagega, what will characterize that steady state. ठीक है, so kai baar as I was myself a student and I've seen students also, कई बार हम इस चक्कर में फंस जाते हैं समझने के कि भाई कैसे सिस्टम इक्विलिब्रियम में पहुंचेगा, कि ऐसा क्या होगा, कैसे, यू नो, हाउ विल प्लेयर्स कीप ऑन अपडेटिंग देयर बिलीव्स एंड हाउ विल पीपल, प्लेयर्स कीप ऑन अपडेटिंग देयर स्ट्रैटेजीज सो दैट एट द एंड दे विल रीच स्टेज इन विच दे आर इन इक्विलिब्रियम. एज गेम थ्योरिस्ट वी डोंट केयर अबाउट दैट, राइट. सो एटलीस्ट राइट नाउ वी डोंट केयर अबाउट. We are only interested in characterizing an equilibrium if it exists. ठीक है, तो इन चक्रों में मत पड़ जाना क्योंकि उसे बहुत टाइम वेस्ट होता है और हम बहुत कंफ्यूज जाते हैं कि भाई ऐसा होगा कैसे, या क्या मतलब है इसका, कैसे पहुँचेंगे हम, पहुँच जाएंगे या सही पहुँचेंगे या नहीं पहुँचेंगे. अगर है, अगर पहुँच गए तो ऐसा दिखेगा, राइट. एंड द फाइनल पॉइंट, रिमेंबर, एनी इक्विलिब्रियम को जज नहीं करना है इन टर्म्स ऑफ इट्स एफिशिएंसी, इन टर्म्स ऑफ इट्स फेयरनेस. एन इक्विलिब्रियम मे और मे नॉट बी एफिशिएंट, इट मे और मे नॉट बी फेयर, है ना. हमने यही सिस्टम बहुत जगह देख लिया कि जैसे प्रिजनर्स डिलेमा का इक्विलिब्रियम इट्स डेफिनेटली नॉट एफिशिएंट, राइट. फॉर एग्जांपल यू हैव सेबाक और स्ट्रेविंस्की है जो तुम्हारा बैटल ऑफ सेक्सेस है, इट्स नॉट फेयर, राइट. विच एवर इक्विलिब्रियम यू आर इन, इफ बोथ ऑफ यू आर गोइंग टू स्टैंड अप देन इट्स नॉट फेयर टू से अंजलि, इफ बोथ ऑफ यू आर गोइंग टू क्लबिंग इट्स नॉट फेयर टू राहुल. इक्विलिब्रिया आर नॉट मेंट टू बी जज्ड इन टर्म्स ऑफ एफिशिएंसी ऑफ फेयरनेस, दे आर ओनली डिस्क्रिप्शंस ऑफ स्टेडी स्टेट्स. ठीक है, तो इन सब चीज़ों से ऊपर उठ के इक्विलिब्रियम को समझना है. इन सब चीज़ों में फंस के यू विल गेन नथिंग इन गेम थ्योरी. दीज आर सेपरेट कंसिडरेशंस, नॉट पार्ट ऑफ गेम थ्योरी. ऑलराइट, सो नाउ लेट अस टॉक अबाउट फाइंडिंग अ मिक्स स्ट्रेटजी नैश इक्विलिब्रियम. हमने ये किया था व्हेन वी वर फाइंडिंग नैश प्योर स्ट्रेटजी नैश इक्विलिब्रियम, वी वर एसेंशियली यूजिंग बेस्ट रिस्पॉन्सेस. द टेक्निक हियर इज स्लाइटली डिफरेंट एंड अ लिटिल मोर इन्वॉल्व्ड. सो लेट्स टेक दैट स्टेप बाई स्टेप. वॉट वी वॉन्ट टू डू इज वी वॉन्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट हाउ टू फाइंड द मिक्स स्ट्रेटजी नैश इक्विलिब्रियम ऑफ अ पर्टिकुलर गेम, राइट. सो देर आर थ्री स्टेप्स टू इट. द फर्स्ट स्टेप इज दैट यू eliminate strictly dominated strategies, actions or strategies. जब they cannot be part of any equilibrium, तो उनके बारे में बात करने का point ही नहीं है. फालतू में तुम उन्हें probability assign करोगे and it will complicate your calculation. ठीक है. Second is that for each player, right, you have to calculate her mixed strategy, right. Just bear with me, things will get clear when we do example. For each player, calculate her mixed strategy such that the other player is made indifferent between her rationalizable, I'll just explain what the word is, rationalizable strategies. All right. And the third is solve to get your mixed strategy Nash. So what we have over here is that this is the crucial step, right? This is the first step is to simplify. The last step is simply calculation. The second step is crucial. For every player, you have to calculate her mixed strategy such that the other player is made indifferent between her strategies. Okay? Or the third term that is important is that rationalizable strategies, which essentially mean कि जब तुमने यहाँ से strictly dominated strategies को eliminate कर दिया तो जो remainder strategies होते हैं उनको बोलते हैं rationalizable. मतलब जो strategies एक rational player actual में choose करने वाले हैं equilibrium. ठीक है. So this is the terminology that Watson uses. That's why I've used specifically over here. So let's work with the first example. Example 1, which is called lobbying. So the story of this game is that there are two players, which are essentially two firms, okay, and the firms are lobbying for some contract or something with the government, right. So the options, so they have two options. They can either choose to lobby and they can choose not to lobby, okay. And lobbying is not a costless exercise. So the cost of lobbying is 15 units, jo bhi units tum sochna chaho soch sakte ho. The cost is 15, and of course not lobbying is costless, right. So how the game is structured is that if both the firms lobby, right, or both the firms don't lobby, if both the firms are lobbying or not lobbying but doing the same thing, then the government takes a neutral decision, right? It doesn't favor any one firm. So both lobby or don't lobby, if both are taking the same action, then the government takes a neutral decision. And this means that the payoff is 10 to each firm. All right. The final payoff, ये तो वो है कि गवर्नमेंट की तरफ से जो आया उसके बाद तुम्हें कितना बेनिफिट मिला ऑफ वॉट एवर न्यूट्रल डिसीजन द गवर्नमेंट टुक. द फाइनल पे ऑफ ऑफकोर्स विल बी दिस माइनस हाउ मच यू स्पेंट ऑन लॉबी. सो इस केस में दो केसेस होंगे, सपोज नन ऑफ यू लॉबीड, सो देन द पे ऑफ टू एवरी बोथ द फर्म विल बी 10. बट इफ बोथ ऑफ यू लॉबीड एंड देन गवर्नमेंट टुक अ न्यूट्रल डिसीजन, देन 10 माइनस 15 फॉर ईच फर्म एंड द पे ऑफ विल बी माइनस 5. Right, so payoff will be 10 minus whatever cost you spent on either lobbying or don't lobby. Right, now what happens when one firm lobbies and the other firm does not? Case one is that firm two lobbies and firm one does not. ठीक है, तो इसमें पहले हमें बताया कि इसका firm two का cost हो गया 15 और firm one का cost हो गया 0. इस केस में क्या होगा, that whoever lobbies government essentially just favors that firm, right? So that means that government favors F2, and in this case F2 gets 30, and F1 gets 0, right? So then the final payoff will be what? For F2 it will be 30 minus 15, because 30 is the payoff that the firm got because of the government favor, but the firm also lobbied, so 15 was subtracted. For firm 1, this is essentially 0 because there was no gain, but there was also no cost, right? The second case is that firm 1 lobbies and firm 2 does not lobby, right? In this case, of course, government favors firm 1, or इस केस में फर्म वन को मिलता है बेनिफिट ऑफ 40, राइट? सो इट्स एसिमेट्रिक, दिस फर्म्स आर एसिमेट्रिक, सिमेट्रिक नहीं है. अगर फर्म टू को फेवर मिलता है, सो द बेनिफिट इज 30, वेयर एज द बेनिफिट टू फर्म टू इन केस ऑफ फेवर इज 40, राइट? सो द फाइनल पे ऑफ्स इन दिस केस विल लुक लाइक फर्म टू के लिए 0 होगा. And for firm 1, you will have 40 minus 15 because firm 1 lobbied, and this will be 25. ठीक है? So what we can do is, let's just draw a matrix that reflects, and then we can work easily with the matrix. You have firm 1, firm 2, lobby or not lobby. If both lobby, then it's a neutral decision. Both get 10 but have spent more in lobbying. If both do not lobby, then both get 10, right? If firm 1 lobbies but firm 2 does not, firm 1 ko milta hai 25, firm 2 ko 0. And in this case, firm 1 gets 0 and firm 2 gets 15, right? So first thing that we can quickly do, so our purpose is to find mixed strategy Nash equilibrium. But the first thing that we can quickly do is to look for pure strategy Nash equilibrium. Right, so if the first, if firm 2, right, if firm 2 lobbies, then what we have, the best response of firm 1 is to not lobby. If firm 2 is not lobbying, then the best response of firm 1 is to lobby. Similarly, for the other case, if firm 1 is going to lobby, then the best response of firm 2 is not, and if the firm is 1 is not going to lobby, then it's best, in the best interest of firm 2, to lobby. So what we have is that there are already two pure strategy Nash equilibria over here, which is lobby comma not lobby and not lobby comma lobby. ठीक है, तो ये कुछ ऐसा हमारा कोऑर्डिनेशन गेम या फिर हॉक डो, ऑल दीज काइंड्स ऑफ गेम्स, उस टाइप का एक हमारा इक्विलिब्रियम यहाँ पर है. देर आर टू प्योर स्ट्रेटजी नैश इक्विलिब्रियम, बट लेट्स ऑल्सो ट्राई एंड फाइंड आउट मिक्स्ड स्ट्रेटजी नैश इक्विलिब्रियम, राइट. सो फॉर दिस वी हैड थ्री स्टेप्स. फर्स्ट स्टेप वॉज टू एलिमिनेट एनी स्ट्रिक्टली डोमिनेटेड स्ट्रेटजीज. वी सी दैट देर आर नो स्ट्रिक्टली डोमिनेटेड स्ट्रेटजीज फॉर एनी फर्म, राइट. सो नो एलिमिनेशन इन द फर्स्ट स्टेज. नाउ द सेकेंड स्टेज इज क्रूशियल टू अंडरस्टैंड. इसको समझने के लिए थोड़ा सा बैकवर्ड सोचना है. हम क्या कोशिश कर रहे हैं, राइट. वी आर स्टार्टिंग, वी आर थिंकिंग दैट वॉट मिक्स्ड स्ट्रैटेजी विल बी एन ऑप्टिमल स्ट्रैटेजी फॉर एवरी फर्म, राइट. सो सपोज वी आर थिंकिंग फ्रॉम द पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू ऑफ फर्म वन, राइट. वॉट सपोज फर्म वन इज थिंकिंग के लेट मी ट्राई अ मिक्स्ड स्ट्रैटेजी, लेट मी ट्राई ए प्रोबेबिलिटी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ओवर लॉबिंग एंड नॉट लॉबिंग. वेन विल फर्म वन डिसाइड टू गो फॉर अ मिक्स्ड स्ट्रैटेजी, राइट. द सीधा सीधा आंसर इज के इट एक्सपेक्ट्स द फर्म टू ऑल्सो दैट इट एक्सपेक्ट्स दैट द फर्म टू इज ऑल्सो गोइंग फॉर अ मिक्स्ड स्ट्रैटेजी. क्यों? क्योंकि अगर उसको लग रहा है कि फर्म वन, अगर उसका बिलीफ ऐसा है कि फर्म टू इज गोइंग टू चूज अ प्योर स्ट्रैटेजी, देन वी ऑलरेडी नो कि प्योर स्ट्रैटेजी का बेस्ट रिस्पॉन्स क्या है, राइट. इफ फर्म वन बिलीव्स दैट फर्म टू इज गोइंग टू गो फॉर अ प्योर स्ट्रैटेजी, फॉर एग्जाम्पल फर्म वन बिलीव्स दैट फर्म टू इज गोइंग टू चूज एल, राइट, देन देर इज अ यूनिक बेस्ट रिस्पॉन्स टू दैट. द यूनिक बेस्ट रिस्पॉन्स इज टू नॉट लॉबी, राइट. एंड देन अ मिक्स्ड स्ट्रैटेजी कैनॉट बी अ बेस्ट रिस्पॉन्स टू दिस, क्योंकि हमें पता है ऑलरेडी इसका बेस्ट रिस्पॉन्स हमें वी ऑलरेडी नो इट्स एन. इफ ऑन द अदर हैंड द फर्म वन बिलीव्स दैट द अदर फर्म इज नॉट गोइंग टू लॉबी, इसका बेस्ट रिस्पॉन्स भी है. सो द ओनली वे इन विच फर्म वन इज गोइंग टू रैंडमाइज, इज गोइंग टू चूज अ मिक्स स्ट्रैटेजी, if it expects the other firm to also randomize, right. Now what exact a randomization of the other firm will make it optimal for firm 1 to randomize. So how we are thinking is that firm 1 has a pure strategy best response to every pure strategy of firm 2, right. If firm 1 believes that firm 2 is going to play a pure strategy, then firm 1 will not play a mixed strategy. The only way in which firm 1 is going to play a mixed strategy is if it believes that firm 2 is also going to play a mixed strategy, right. So what exactly that mixed strategy will be such that it is optimal for firm 1 to randomize, okay. So फॉर दैट वॉट वी विल नीड टू डू इज अब फॉर्म टू का सपोज फॉर्म वन बिलीव्स दैट थेटा टू इज इक्वल टू सम क्यू कॉमा वन माइनस क्यू, विच मीन्स दैट फॉर्म वन बिलीव्स दैट फॉर्म टू विल प्ले लॉबिंग विद प्रॉबिलिटी क्यू वन एंड नॉट लॉबिंग विद प्रॉबिलिटी वन माइनस क्यू, ठीक है. अगर ये बिलीफ है, so then what will be the expected utility to firm 1 from lobbying, right. If this is, let me assign probabilities over here, this is q and this is 1 minus q, right. So the expected utility from playing l, so we are in this row now, the expected utility from playing L is a weighted average of minus 5 and 25, right, and the weights are Q and 1 minus Q respectively, ठीक है, ये हमने किया है. So the expected payoff from playing L is what? It is minus 5 plus 1 minus Q times 25, correct, which is nothing but 25 minus 30 Q, Similarly, the expected utility from playing not lobbying. So then we are in this zone, right? Or is case mein, 0 gets a probability of Q, 10 gets a probability of 1 minus Q, right? So that is your Q times 0 plus 1 minus Q times 10, which is 10 minus 10 Q. Now, if firm 1 is planning to randomize, hai na? तो इसका मतलब कि उसको L और N से इन एक्सपेक्टेशन इक्वल पे ऑफ मिलना चाहिए. दैट मीन्स द एक्सपेक्टेड पे ऑफ फ्रॉम L एंड N शुड बी इक्वल. इफ दे आर नॉट इक्वल, इफ एन एक्सपेक्टेशन, अगर तुम प्लान बना रहे हो और तुम्हें क्लियरली दिख रहा है के इन एक्सपेक्टेशन यू आर गेटिंग अ हायर पे ऑफ फ्रॉम एल, वाई विल यू मिक्स बिटवीन एल एंड एन? तुम कभी भी एन क्यों ही चूज करोगे, राइट? सो इन एक्सपेक्टेशन फॉर फर्म वन टू फाइंड इट ऑप्टिमल टू डू अ मिक्स ऑफ दीज स्ट्रेटजीज, डू अ मिक्स ऑफ एल एंड एन, इट शुड बी द केस. सो फॉर रैंडमाइजेशन to be optimal for firm 1, it must be the case that the expected utility from L is exactly equal to the expected utility from N. Agar inme se koi bhi bada hai, the other one will never be chosen, correct? So then what we find is that we use these equations. We have 25 minus 30 Q is equal to 10 minus 10 Q. 25 minus 30 Q is equal to 10 minus 10 Q, which gives us Q is equal to 3 by 4. You can do this calculation. अभी देखो यहाँ पे क्या हुआ. हमने शुरू किया था firm 1 से, right? And we did this back calculation that for firm 1, to find it optimal to randomize, firm 2 should be randomizing. And firm 2 should be randomizing how? Firm 2 should be randomizing like this. Firm 2 should be placing probability 3 by 4 on L and probability 1 by 4 on N. So, jab hum firm 1 ke taraf se solve karna shuru kiye, what we got actually is the strategy, mixed strategy for firm 2, right? That's why this is the statement that we had earlier, that for each player over here, just look, for each player calculate her mixed strategy such that the other player is made indifferent between her rationalizable strategies. Matlab, for each player firm 2 ke liye उसका मिक्स स्ट्रेटजी ऐसे कैलकुलेट होगा सच दैट फर्म वन, इन दिस केस द अदर फर्म इज फर्म वन, सच दैट फर्म वन इज इनडिफरेंट बिटवीन हर स्ट्रेटजीज. इनडिफरेंट होने के लिए क्या होगा? व्हाट द रिक्वायरमेंट इज दैट द एक्सपेक्टेड पे ऑफ इज इक्वल फ्रॉम ऑल हर स्ट्रेटजीज. एंड दिस इज एग्जैक्टली व्हाट. So this is the mixed strategy. This is the mixed strategy of firm 2 that will make firm 1 indifferent. That will make it optimal for firm 1 to randomize. Ab ye same kaam hum firm 2 ke liye karenge, right? So now what we are going to do is we are going to find the mixed strategy of firm 1 that will make it optimal for firm 2 to optimize. Okay? So similarly, you have that firm 2 will mix, right? If it believes that firm 1 mixes, right? So suppose theta 1 is equal to sum P1 minus P. And in this case, what we will have is that the expected utility to firm 2 from playing L will be what? Now we have assigned probabilities over here. We are saying that this is p and this is 1 minus p, right? So if we are saying that firm 2 ka expected utility kya hoga from playing L, then we are in this zone. There are two payoffs, minus 5 and 15. Minus 5 gets a probability of P, 15 gets a probability of 1 minus P. Similarly, when we will work with N, we will have 0 getting a probability of P and 10 getting a probability of 1 minus P. Okay? So, ye dono cheeze I'm just going to write over here. What you have is expected utility from L, you get P times minus 5 plus 1 minus P times. So this simplifies 215 minus 20p. And similarly, the expected utility that 2 gets from playing N, given his belief, given the firm's belief about player 1's mixed strategy, right? This is equal to p times 0 plus 1 minus p times 10, right? So what we have is 10 minus 10, and the same argument for mixing to be optimal, it has to be the case that the utility that firm 2 is getting from each of these pure strategies, the expected utility, is exactly equal, and this implies that your p is equal to. Alright, so the third step then is to combine this information. What we have is that sigma, the mixed strategy, which is a Nash equilibrium, looks like this. Firm 1 places probability half and half on L and N, while firm 2 places probability 3 by 4 and 1 by 4 on L and N respectively. This is the mixed strategy Nash equilibrium. Alright, so what do we make of this? We make of it that if firm 1, right, again equilibrium hai, toh belief or strategy will coincide. Belief and actual reality will coincide. So then we can use the terms interchangeably, because we are talking about equilibrium, we will use the term strategy. Okay, so what we have over here is that the mixed strategy of firm 1, which places a probability of half and half on lobbying and not lobbying, and the mixed strategy of firm 2, which places a probability of 3 by 4 on lobbying and 1 by 4 on not lobbying, right? These are equilibrium. If suppose firm 1 jo hai, wo ek fair coin toss karke decide kar raha hai that how to whether to go for lobbying or not lobbying, and firm 2 is using a loaded coin, okay? Whatever comes up, they decide accordingly. If they are deciding according to this mixed strategy, then none of them will want to deviate, because in equilibrium their expected payoffs from both their pure strategies is exactly. So none of the pure strategies will get any extra weight in expectation, right? And both the firms will be in equilibrium. Ab actual mein kya hoga? Kabhi koi ek firm ka lobby ho jayega, kabhi koi dusre firm ka not lobbying ho jayega, right? Actual mein to yahi hoga. Kabhi dono firms ne lobby kar liya, kabhi dono firms ne lobby nahi kiya. The actual outcome can be anything out of the four, because all four of the boxes actually have positive probabilities. So the actual outcome can be anything, right? But as long as the probabilities, or as long as the mixing before the game, right, are done according to these probabilities, no firm will want to deviate. Okay, so this is the idea of a mixed strategy Nash equilibrium. Let us work with another example to make the idea more concrete. So the second example is what happens in sports. Okay. ठीक है, इसमें मैंने एक बार पहले एग्जांपल दिया था वेयर वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द गोली शॉट इन चक दे इंडिया, राइट? सो द एक्शन इज नॉट एग्जैक्टली साइमल्टेनियस, राइट? वंस द शूटर मेक्स अ शॉट, ओनली देन द गोली डिफेंस, बट इट हैपन्स सो क्विकली दैट एसेंशियली इट्स साइमल्टेनियस मूव, बिकॉज वंस यू डिसाइड एज अ गोली, वंस यू डिसाइड दैट यू आर गोइंग टू जम्प टू द लेफ्ट, after that you cannot go back on that decision, right? So similarly, this similar type of idea has been used in this game where it's about tennis, right? So tennis mein you have two players, one is serving and one is receiving. Same kind of thing happens. The move is not simultaneous technically, right? But it happens so fast that once you are committed to an action, you cannot go back. Right, so the in this game, what we will have is you will have players which are two tennis players, right? So you have two tennis players. These are lawn tennis players, not your TT players. The actions. Now there are two players. एक है जो serve कर रहा है, the server. One is the receiver. Okay, the server can decide to either serve a forehand, serve in the center, or serve a backhand. So if you've seen tennis anytime, you know that there is in the entire court the front portion will be called the forehand. ठीक है, मतलब जब तुम serve करो तो सामने ही गिर जाए, ball टप्पा खा जाए, right? Or you place your ball in the center, or you place your ball at the back. In the back end of the court of the other player, right? And as a receiver also, you have to decide accordingly that where do you want to stand, because if you are committed to suppose standing in the forehand and the service person, the other player who is servicing, sends the ball at the backhand, to tab tum turant wahan pe daud ke nahi ja paoge, right? Or even if you can, it will not be as efficient as it would have been if you were actually standing in the back, right? So similar idea with what we had in the Chak De India shot, that if the goalie has to decide that where she will jump before the striker makes the shot, right? So if she commits herself to jumping to the left and the striker makes a shot to the center, right, then wahan se kood ke beech mein wo wapas nahi aa sakta, theek hai na? So in that sense, this is essentially, matlab, it boils down to a simultaneous move game, even though in time there's a difference of seconds or lesser than a second. ठीक है ना? तो उस केस में the idea is that the server will want to place the ball where the receiver is not, and the receiver will want to receive the ball, will want to be placed where the server is going to basically serve the shot. हाँ, तो ये तो मतलब द आइडिया इज सिमिलर टू मैचिंग पेनीज. वन वॉन्ट्स दैट देर शुड बी नो मैचिंग, राइट? द सर्वर डजेंट वॉन्ट द पोजिशन ऑफ द बॉल टू मैच विद द पोजिशन ऑफ द रिसीवर, एंड द रिसीवर वॉन्ट्स दैट द पोजिशन ऑफ दैट हर पोजिशन शुड मैच विद द पोजिशन ऑफ द बॉल, राइट? सो अगेन, दिस इज अ प्योरली कॉन्फ्लिक्चुअल गेम. नाउ द पे ऑफ्स, वी विल जस्ट यूज दिस पे ऑफ मैट्रिक्स, ऑलराइट? So this is the game that we have. Now you can quickly, for your own practice, you can check that there will actually be no pure strategy Nash equilibrium in this. For the mixed strategy Nash equilibrium, right? Let's start with the first step. Let us start by eliminating any strictly dominated strategies. From the player one's perspective, see that F is strictly dominated by B. When player 2, right, when player 2 plays F, it's better to play backhand than to go for forehand. If player 2 is in center, again better to go for backhand than forehand. If the other player is at the backhand, better to go for backhand. Theek hai? That means that you can clearly eliminate this. Now, that doesn't stop there. If, for example, if you started with player 2, you will find that for player 2, F is not strictly dominated by any other action, right? But how will player 2 reason? Player 2 ka reasoning ye hai ki agar player 1 ke upar aata hai, player 1 will actually never play F because B will always strictly dominate F, right? So now that this row is eliminated from the game, now F becomes strictly dominated for player 2 as well. Why? You see that C dominates F over here. Again, C dominates F over here. So what we have is that F, or rather B, strictly dominates F for player 1, and C strictly dominates F for player 2. So we have this also gone now. Right? So we have eliminated strictly dominated strategies from the game. So ab hum unhe consider nahi karna, hamara calculation ho jayega simple. Okay? So now let's move to the second step. So in the first step, we have eliminated F for both. Second step mein fir hume wohi steps follow karne. If it is optimal for player 1 to randomize, that means that it has to come from some optimal, some randomization strategy for player of player 2. Okay? So if that is the case, suppose player 2 places a probability of Q on C and 1 minus Q on B. Okay? What we will have is that for player 1, the expected utility of player 1 from playing C is 0 times Q, 3 times 1 minus Q. Okay? So this is 0 times Q plus 3 times 1 minus Q. This is the expected payoff. The expected payoff of, again, player 1 from playing backhand. This is 3 times Q, 2 times 1 minus Q. 3Q plus 2, 1 minus Q. Right? Now, when you equalize them, you get the value of Q. So, expected utility of 1 from C, and if it has to equal, if it has to equal the expected utility of 1 from B, it has to be the case that your Q is equal to 1 by 4. Similarly, if player 1, now thinking from the perspective of player 2, if player 1 is placing a probability of P and 1 minus P on C and B respectively, right, what you will have is, if player 2 chooses to place C, then the expected payoff is 5 times P plus 2 times 1 minus P. So the expected utility of player 2 from playing C is 5 times P plus 2 times 1 minus P. Similarly, the expected utility of player 2 from playing backhand, you will have over here, you have 2 times P plus 3 times 1 minus P. Again, for player 2 to be indifferent between these two strategies, player 1 has to randomize in such a way that P is equal to 1 by 4. Right. So the final step is to write these strategies. Now be careful over here. the strategy sigma, which is equal to sigma 1 comma sigma 2, this is equal to where player 1 assigns probability 0 to f. Remember, har action ke liye ek probability hai. You cannot miss an action. So you assign, player 1 has to assign 0 to playing forward, 1 by 4 to playing center, 3 by 4 to playing backhand. And similarly, player 2 has to assign probability 0 to playing forward, 1 by 4 to playing center, and 3 by 4 to playing backhand. And this combination is a mixed strategy Nash equilibrium of this game. Alright, so again, what we have done is that we have calculated mixed strategies for players such that they are best responses to each other, right? And in equilibrium, the beliefs will be true, the beliefs will be correct. So player one expects, player two to play like this, player two expects player one to play like this. In equilibrium, they will actually play like this. So 1/4 of the time, player one or the server is going to serve in the center. Most of the time, 3/4 of the times, she's going to serve in the back. Player two will predict this correctly, will have correct beliefs about it. So 3/4 of the time, she will actually stay at the back, and 1/4 of the time, she will stay in the center. Right. So this is not something that is just for our exercise or maths. Numerical play I'm kar rahe hain. This is actually how players actually play. You will see that. So there are actually studies that have studied the behavior of players, how whether they have a particular strategy ki har bar backhand hi de rahe hain, har bar forehand hi de rahe hain, ya center mein serve kar rahe hain, or whether they are randomizing, right? And you will see that a lot of new players are actually unable to randomize, and if they are paired against an experienced player, they keep on, getting penalized for that behavior. And over time, they learn that, they have to randomize. Okay. So because it's a game, if the other player can judge your move before you move, then the other player will be ready. So, tumhara as a server kaam hai, dusre player ko trick karna. And as a receiver, the work of a player is to judge the other person's move before the other person moves, make a cut. That's why the movie was about the coach being really experienced, right? And the coach could just make correct judgment about how the player, how the striker is going to take the shot. So this is the idea. And if there was no randomization, then the coach would immediately know that ये तो हमेशा center shot ही लेती है, ये तो हमेशा left hand shot ही लेती है. So then there was no question of making any guesses or beliefs or mixing the strategy, because to a center shot there is a pure strategy best response for the goalie to stay in the center. So अगर यही चल रहा होता, so there was no as a server, then you are always at a loss. Because you don't want the pennies to match. You want the pennies to be different. Right? So that's why players mix. So mixing, a mixed strategy is actually the way players actually strategize or play their game. Okay. So I will stop here. This is it from your unit 1. So we have covered topics from Osborne as well as Watson. We have covered your simultaneous move games of complete information, right? So where players are moving simultaneously. We have covered various kinds of examples, examples that can be depicted in matrices, examples that cannot be depicted in matrices. We have covered best responses, we have covered dominated strategies, strict non-strict equilibrium, and we've also covered mixed strategy Nash equilibrium, beliefs and using beliefs and mixed strategies and expected payoffs. Alright, so this ends our unit 1 for us. I really encourage you to do the practice questions on your own. Follow the strategy that we have done here in the class. It will just come very naturally to you. And the more you practice, the better. The game theory is a paper where these kind of numericals will be dominant in your question paper. Okay? So any problem you have, you are free to reach out to me. So I will see you in the next session where we'll start with unit 2. Thank you. Bye-bye.